Hello my dear students, and also welcome back to the study of fluid kinematics. In the previous video lectures we have derived one dimensional continuity equation in terms of mass flow rate, that is m dot is equal to rho into a into v, where rho is the density of the fluid, a is the flow area which is perpendicular to the direction of the flow, and v is the average velocity. This is the average velocity here. This one we have derived. It is also called as the conservation of mass. We have derived. And in the next, in continuation of that continuity equation, now we will derive the three-dimensional continuity equation, that is also in Cartesian coordinates. Cartesian coordinates means what? Cartesian coordinates means, these are also called the rectangular that coordinates. See, in the simple way we can tell this one now, x, y, z. All the coordinates are in the linear coordinates, x, y, z. For example, if this is taken as one cube here now, in this cube we can identify that Cartesian coordinates. How this one? For example, this edge is there, this is the x-axis, this edge is there, this is the y-axis, and this edge is there, this is the z-axis here now. So therefore this is called as the Cartesian coordinate system here now. So similarly, we have taken some usual notations, that is the always along the x-axis here now. See here, along the x-axis small u is the velocity, along the y-axis, that is the small v is the velocity, and along the z-axis here now, that is having the velocity small w here now. So therefore here, to derive this three-dimensional continuity equation, we are assuming one cubical, very small, infinitesimally small element of its dimensions here now. Along the x-axis it is having a dx here now, this is a dx, and this is the dy, and this is the dz. Means this is a very small element, cubical element, and also it is a fluid element, and it has a volume of dx, dy, dz here. So now we will derive with the help of one dimensional continuity equation, that is a mass flow rate is equal to rho a v, we will derive the three dimensional continuity equation. So now I will assume cube of a fluid element. So this is the cube of the fluid element here now. So this is the one, that cube of the fluid element. So therefore this is the cube of the fluid element here now. As I have told, this is the x direction here now, and this is the y direction here now, and this is the z direction here. And u is the velocity along the, small u is the velocity along the x direction, small v is the velocity along the y direction, and small w is the velocity along the z direction here now. And it is having a size or a dimensions here now. Along the x axis it is having a dx here now, and along the y axis it is having a dy here now, and along the z axis it is having here now, it is the dz here in this case. So total volume of this element is dx, dy and dz. Now I will apply first along the x direction the mass flow rate is how much. That one we will take here now. So for that I will take two faces along the x direction here now. One face, it is a left face here now. This is a left face here in this case. So this is, I will call it as A, B, C and D here now. And the right faces of this one element here now, E here, F and G and H here. H here. So So like that, if I take, this is the one small element here, no? This face is the right face, this face is the left face. It is fluid entering at this face, A, B, C, D face, and leaving at this face, E, F, G, H here now. So now along this x direction, I will take along the x direction, I will take here now. Along the x direction, the fluid entering, that means at the face A, B, C, D, at the face A, B, C, D, fluid entering is what here now? That is here, mass flow rate is equal to rho A, P. Here, rho is the density of the fluid, because we are assuming here now it is an incompressible fluid, so therefore density is remains constant. And A is the flow area. What is the flow area here now? This flow area is, this is dy, and this is what here now? This is the dz here. So this is the flow area here, this is the dy, and this is the dz here now. This is the flow area at the A, B, C, D here. So therefore, the flow area is, it is dy into dz here. Next one is what here? Velocity. Velocity along the x direction is, it is the u here. So this is what? This is the mass flow rate entering at the face A, B, C, D here. So mass flow rate exit, once it will enter, the mass will not be, it is a conserved. It is entering and exit here now. Exit at this phase, EFGH phase. So it will be found by the Taylor series of expansion. So therefore, mass exit at EFGH phase. This phase. It is exit here, entry, exit here now. It is entering here now. Entry, this is the ABCD, is the entry here now. Exit is this one. This is the exit here. How to write here? By the Taylor series of expansion. So what is the Taylor series of expansion? First, how much it is the entering mass flow rate, that has to be taken, rho dy dz into u here now. Then next, plus what? Differentiation, because mass flow rate is varying along this x direction up to the distance dx here now. So therefore, we have to differentiate according to the Taylor series of expansion here now. So plus here, so dou f dou x, here differentiation with respect to x here now. What has to differentiate? Total this quantity has to be differentiated here now. Rho dy dz into u here now. This quantity has to differentiate. But how much has to differentiate? Up to this distance dx. So therefore into dx here. This is the total mass flow rate exit of the face at the right face of this one, EFGH here now. So net mass flow rate is what here now? The net mass flow rate along the x direction. It is what? This minus this here now. If I made this minus this, this will become a positive, this will become a negative here now. This one will get cancel. So therefore, net mass flow rate along the x direction here now, it is minus dou by dou x. Just I will rearrange this term here now. Rho u, I will write it in the bracket only. And dx, dy and dz, I will write it here. So what I am getting here now, this is the mass flow rate, net mass flow rate along the x direction. So next one is, similarly if I found along the y direction, the same concept if I applied, what I am getting here now, these two equation I am getting, only variation is here now u. In place of u, p will come along the y direction. In place of the z direction, so in case of the z direction, in place of u, that is a w will come here now. Other things will become, remains same at the net mass flow rate here now. Just I will write it here, mass flow rate along the, that similarly, along the, that is a y direction, along the y direction, this is equal to what? Minus dou rho, and it is a v. In place of u here, v will come divided by dou y here, because we are taken that mass flow rate along the y direction here now. And dx, dy and dz, volume of the element, it is same here now. And similarly, next one is a z direction here now. This is equal to minus dou rho w divided by dou z dx, dy and dz here now. So, these are the three equations we are getting here now. Then next one is total mass flow rate. What is the total mass flow rate? Adding of these three here. So, therefore, the total mass flow rate here now. Total, that is mass flow, it is rate here. That is equal to, I will add this plus this plus this, this here. So, I will add all this. So, now this will become the total mass flow rate, which is of the total cubical element here. That is minus dou rho u divided by dou x, then dx, dy and dz minus dou rho v divided by, it is a dou y, dx, dy and dz minus dou rho w divided by dou z dx, dy and dz here. This is equation what I am getting here now. Equation number 1. Call it is equation number 1 here now. So next one is what here now? The mass flow rate, total mass flow rate, also we can write here now. Also we can write the total mass flow rate, that mass flow rate is equal to, also we can write here now. How this one now? Dou rho divided by dou t into volume dx, dy and dz here. This is also a total mass flow rate here. How this one? The density divided by this change of the time, change of the density here for the compressible flow. And the next one is dx, dy, dz. Rho means what? It is a kg per meter cube here now. And per time means what? It is a second here. So this one is, it is a volume here, meter cube. This meter cube, this meter cube will get cancelled. Answer we are getting here now, kg per second in SI here. That means what? This is also a mass flow rate. What we will do here now? I will take, this is a equation number 2 here. So what is this? Both the equations are same. This is also a total net mass flow rate, total mass flow rate, total net mass flow rate. And this is also a total mass flow rate here now. So therefore, I will equate equation number 1 and 2 here. So therefore, here, equation number 1 is equal to equation number 2 here. What it will happen by doing like this here now? Here one thing is common. Dx, dy, dz, dx, dy, dz, dx, dy, dz. At the left side, it is a common here now. And at the right side, here also dx, dy, dz. So therefore, all these will get cancelled at the left and right side here now. So therefore, at the last, the next, what we are getting? This dou rho by dou t, it is left here now. That one also I will take. That one also I will take the left side, or else this total terms is there. I will take at the right side here now. This negative sign will become a positive sign. What I am getting here now? Dou rho u divided by dou x plus dou rho v divided by dou y plus dou rho w divided by dou z plus here plus dou rho divided by dou t is equal to 0. This is called as the three-dimensional continuity equation in Cartesian coordinates here now. So, this is about the three-dimensional continuity equation. As some analysis will come on this equation here now. So, that analysis we will see in the next video lecture. Some analysis on this three-dimensional continuity equation here now. We'll see in the next video lecture. Thank you. Thank you very much.